Next, a look at how the White House shapes the presidential image and a possible truce between the press corps and the Obama administration over access to the president. NewsHour congressional correspondent Kwame Holman has our story.
These are familiar images to many Americans, all captured by official White House photographer Pete Souza. They show private moments, President Barack Obama speaking with Pakistani activist Malala Yousafzai, or lunching with former Secretary of State Hillary Clinton. But many others were taken while news photographers covering the president were excluded, such as during Mr. Obama's Air Force One flight to South Africa with former President George W. Bush. Such examples have caused a simmering feud between the White House and the press, with photographers and reporters arguing their access to the president is more restricted than in the past. McClatchy Newspaper's senior White House correspondent, Stephen Thoma.
We expect a small group of journalists at a minimum to be allowed into the room in the White House or elsewhere when he's meeting with a foreign leader, when he's meeting with his cabinet. We are granted that access less and less since this White House took over in 2009.
Of course, there are some remarkable moments the press never would be asked to witness, but others are not so extraordinary. And there's the rub, says Thoma, president of the White House Correspondents Association.
Increasingly, as they release their own photos and video of these events, it underscores to us as a press corps that they know these are of public interest.
Guys.
The tension spilled into White House Press Secretary Jay Carney's regular briefing last week.
Complaining about this.
That you think it's a, you think this has not been...
I would acknowledge that absolutely we need to, that we're going to work with the press and with the photographers to try to address some of their concerns. What I can also assure you is that we will not create a day that has never existed, at least in modern times, when everyone in the White House press corps is satisfied with the amount of access they get to the president. That would be, I think, impossible to expect.
Images matter to every White House, according to Martha Joint Kumar, a political scientist at Towson University who studies the presidency and the media.
Pictures really send a message to people that it's something that speaks directly to them. One aspect I think that's involved here in the photographer's issue is that the White House photographer is to be a photographer not only of the president, following the president around, but it is of the presidency itself as an institution and giving people a sense of what the presidency is and what the White House is, how the White House operates.
Administrations have been using the tools at their disposal for years to relay the president's message and shape how he is viewed by the public.
Staff, a president's staff, tend to be risk averse. And nobody wants to be the person who recommended that the president do the press briefing or take pictures that that get turned against them and have the president say, who recommended this? So nobody wants to be in that position. If the president is the risk taker, because the White House staff reflects the president. It doesn't compliment it.
Mr. Obama was the first president to hire an official White House videographer. Arun Chaudhry followed the president from his 2008 campaign until 2011.
At the White House in the morning, I would probably take a look at the president's schedule and kind of, from a historical perspective, think what are the most important things, you know, to capture for history. I think the president has a lot of back and forth with the media, just like all presidents, and that the issues are fundamentally the same. I think what's changed is the media landscape, the way people get news, the manners in which they are able to access it, and in general, just the economics of how it all works.
Carney and White House staff met Tuesday afternoon with Thoma and others from the press corps to seek some resolution. The press organization said it was encouraged by the meeting and that they would continue an ongoing dialogue with White House staff. The cooperative tone may get an early test. The president leaves Friday for a family vacation in Hawaii, an activity that's given rise in the past to press complaints about access to the president.